Mantour Ministries presents the Mantour Guy Podcast. We may talk about football. We could mention bacon. We might reference Rocky movies. We'll probably discuss the Mantour conferences, but we'll definitely talk about how to grow in our walk with God. Here's your host, the Mantour Guy, Jamie Holden.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Mantour Guy Podcast. This is Jamie Holden here, and I'm so excited that you decided to join us once again this week. Well, in this week's podcast, we're going to bring you one of the messages from one of our past fall conferences the Pendle Potomac District holds every fall. We're approaching the 2021 360 Man Conference. It's coming up soon. It's going to be October 15th and 16th in Lutherville, Maryland. You want to make sure that you get to this conference. And today we're going to be listening to the past message by one of the speakers who's going to be speaking this year at the conference. So we hope you'll take a minute and you'll listen to this podcast as evangelist Reggie Dabb shares his heart about men and how we can serve effectively in the world today. And guys, Reggie's going to be one of the speakers this year at the conference, the 360 Man Conference. So enjoy this message, and it's just a preview of what you can experience this year at the 360 Man Conference.
Y'all ready? Y'all ready? Let's go back in time. Let's go back to another place. Do you remember the Knights of the Round Table? Men who would lay down their life for their king and for their country. When they would sit at that table, they would wait for one man to walk in the room. And when that man walked in the room, every soldier, every warrior, every knight in unison would jump up, and in one voice they would declare, "Long live the king." I was thinking about that because, you see, boys, my favorite movie ever is Braveheart. Love that William Wallace stuff, man. A man who would die for his country. That's awesome. That's why I love when I get to go to military bases and speak to our soldiers and our warriors. I love that stuff. See, other people don't understand, but I do. The sacrifices that a few make so that many can be free. So if you're in this room and either you have or are serving in our military, you might have already done this once. I don't know. But I'm going to do it for me. For 9 years, I worked for a man named Dave Reaver who had half his body blown up in Vietnam. And every time I could do this, I do this. If you're a military veteran or currently serving in the military, if you fought in one of the wars, if you are Coast Guard, that's good enough for me because you keep my fish safe. I want every military, ex-military man in this room to jump up on your feet right now because I want to thank you for your service to the greatest country on the face of the planet Earth. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for what you've done. Thank you for your sacrifice. Thank you. You may be seated. If you want, otherwise do what you want. You earned the right. If you're a Vietnam veteran, don't hang your head. You won. If you hadn't been to Vietnam, you need to go back. You won. What you did that many years ago is living proof today. There are free people in that country because of you. Y'all good? Told you I'm not a preacher. I'm an evangelist. What would happen if today one brother in this room, in this band of brothers, decided that from this day on, that everything you do, that every move you make, that you would decide, long live the king. You drop your kid off at school, long live the king. You do a good job on fixing that car at work, long live the king. Take another bite of that KFC chicken. Long live the king. Today, I'm here to challenge you, to convince you, to urge you to take your life to a whole nother level. I don't care how old you are. You were born for such a time as this. If you're breathing, God has a plan for your life. You ain't at the end of the road. You just took a turn. Now you got something else you get to see. I'm just saying, I'm good, man. I'm 52. I'm proud of it. I look good because black don't crack. Holla. I'm just saying. But here's the deal. Here's the deal today. It's real simple. It's real simple. If you want to live this life, you need to know who lived it before you. If we're going to talk about dedication, let me show you a couple of people who did something so that you can say those words, long live the king. I'm going to start with David, not the king, the boy, the 15-year-old who went up against Goliath. You see, everybody knows the story, but there's a couple of little things I want to just pull out real fast. Oh, by the way, for those of you who are Michigan Wolverine fans, I'll get you out. You can get it on the radio on the way home. I could tell, I could see you got your little blue socks on with your little yellow M on the side. I can see, I know you got your little green on with your little Sparty. Sparty. Your mascot is Sparty, okay? You need to get a new mascot like a lion or something. I don't know. Sparty. Where's Sparty? You're going to die. All right. Fact number one. You know what David did at 15? He killed a lion and a bear in his private life so he could face the giant in public eye. Just thought I'd lay you down on you, man. See, I come across as like some joking little brother, but then I dropped a bomb. Oh, how about this one? Do you know he went by the creek and picked up 5 smooth stones? You know why? Because he did his homework. See, Goliath had 4 brothers just as big as he did. So he didn't just want to kill the one that he saw. He's going to take out the whole family. Isn't that the way we should look at our own sin? We're not here just to take out the one that's getting us. We're going to take them all out. Why? Because you know what? I'm going to make sure my son don't get in the same mess I got in. Y'all ain't in it. Y'all ain't in it to win it. I'm in it to win it. You know, I'm preaching like this. All I'm doing is waving my shirt because somebody in this room needs to get this down because guess what? The devil wants your daughter. But what we do today is going to make him go, can't touch this. Your life dictates how they live. Somebody touch your neighbor and say, all right, all right, all right. Do you know where I came up with that? I got your back. It's real C. It's an old Tennessee thing. I was born and raised in Knoxville, Tennessee. Everybody touch your neighbor and say, never give up. Never give up. Touch your other neighbor and say, never give up. That sounds like something you Pennsylvania people would say. But down south, we got to do something a little more. So here's what we do. Put 2 fingers toward the ground. Put your thumb out like this. Don't go like that. No. Go to Philly. Go like that. You're going to die. All right? That was funny, all right? All the boys from Philly went, yeah, he right, dog. You could lose your life. Yeah, man, go like that or wear a cowboy shirt. Either way, you dead. Stop it. Stop it. I am a cowboy fan. Stop it. Sam, you're supposed to help me, bruh. Sitting over there laughing. They're going to kill him. Two fingers down, thumb out, all right? Here you go. Everybody, let me show you how to do it. You got it. It's emphatic. It's just straight up. This is what I tell kids at school. Everybody just go like this. I just figured out who's from Philly right there, all right? Now look, everybody, look at your neighbor right now and just say, I got your back. Come on, look at the person on the other side of you. Say, I got your back. Come on, y'all got it? That's where it came up when. I do that in schools all the time. You know why? Here's why. Because there's something you don't understand. I'll tell you in a minute, but I got to go back to this. David killed a lion and a bear in his private life so he could kill the giant in the public eye. He took 5 smooth stones because he was going to take out all the giants. He was going to go get the mama and the daddy too if he had to. Why don't we fight for our family like that? Why don't we fight for our wives like that? If you ain't married, learn to fight like that now so you can get a good-looking wife. Do you gotta understand? How you treat people is how you will get in return. I'm telling you, it comes back every time. If you abuse people, you're gonna get abused. If you love, they're gonna love you back. It's just the way it is. Check this out. So David's like, I'll face Goliath. I ain't got no thing. This is it. Everybody say, long live the king.
Long live the king.
Okay, now look, for the rest of the sermon, we gotta go black, y'all. Every time you hear me say, long live the king, you say it back to me. Don't let it decrease. If anything, it should increase. There's not a lot of time left in my sermon. Because you know what I found out at these things? When you're the last speaker, if you go faster, they'll invite you back again. And I know this thing is over at 3:30 and it's only 2:34. I'm hitting for 3 o'clock. Give all the Michigan people a chance to pray one more time. Y'all gonna lose. Okay, let's practice. Long live the king.
Long live the king.
It's just something about man in a room that says stuff. That's just good. That's just good. One more time. Long live the king. So David said, I'll face him, I'll go. Some of y'all looking at me like, I teach this, I learned this in Sunday school. Watch this. So the Bible says this, 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 48. It says, as the Philistine moved closer to attack, David ran quickly toward the battle line to meet him. You know what that means? At 15, he knew he might die. He knew it might be over. He knew he might lose. But there ain't no way he was going to be the last one in the battle. He ran to the battle line. He saw the giant. He says, ah, you ain't beating me to the first punch. It's time for us to go home with a whole new attitude. Hey, you've already forgiven people. You ain't got nothing on your shoulders no more. Hello? You already got it right with Tommy. You ain't got nothing on your shoulder. You already letting love take care of it. You already letting your love, your relationship with God take care of everything else. So what's left? Let's go for the king. Let's work for the king. Somebody say, long live the king.
Long live the king.
If you walk in your house tonight and your wife goes, baby, you're home. How was it? You should scream at her, long live the king.
Long live the king.
And she's going to go, oh, baby, take me to the bedroom. That's what Sarah said. Some of y'all, okay, I'm going for 250 now. 1 Samuel 17, verse 51. David ran and stood over him. He took hold of the Philistine's sword and he killed him. Then he cut his head off. Okay, look. This little brother, 15. 15. 15. And he ain't just killing stuff. He cutting the head off, too. I love when my team goes up by a touchdown. And then another one, and then another one, and then another one. And they just keep pouring it on, pouring it. You know why that makes me happy? Because I know they in it to win it. I think it's time for us to go home. And in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we need to be in it to win it. Long live the king.
Long live the king.
It's getting good, y'all. Y'all ain't good. Y'all, he killed him, then he cut his head off. He go, I know he did, but I'm taking me a trophy. And he did. He carried the head like a trophy. Here it goes. Touch your neighbor and say, here it is. Touch your other neighbor and say, here it is. 1 Samuel 17, 55. As King Saul watched David going out to meet the Philistine, he said to Abner, commander of the army, Abner. What did you have on your chicken today? He said, Abner, whose son is that boy? Somebody touch your neighbor and say, that's weird. Okay, if somebody's about to go beat up your enemy, wouldn't you want to know who they are? Why would you be asking who their daddy is? Some of y'all smart, dude. Some of y'all just beat the black preacher to his point already. Okay, he says, he answered, King, as surely as you live, I don't know. I don't know. So when he came back, holding the head of the giant, I could see this. Because see, 15-year-old boys, they know how to get a little swag. So going out to, see, they're on the front row going. Going out to face the giant, David was like, coming back, he was like, sound guy's like, it's carpet, easy boy. Tommy made fun of you, not me. I love the sound guys. To all the volunteers, to the sound guys, the camera guys, the guys back in the sound and the TV room, thank you for dedicating your time this weekend. Thank you. Thank you, buddy. Thanks for doing this. You guys are awesome. I am here to tell you, you ain't the same brother that you were yesterday. I am here to tell you, you are not going home the way you came in Jesus' name. I'm here to tell you, I know who your daddy is. Your daddy took nothing and made something and called it earth. Your daddy hung earth in nothing and swove everything around it and called it the universe. Your daddy put a plant and made it a plant. Your daddy made the fish and the sky and the sun and the moon. Your daddy made your dog. Your daddy made you. Your daddy is the King of Kings and he's the Lord of Lords. That's your daddy. Now go in his name. And may I add, long live the King. I'm all in. Hate losing. I'm a Cowboy fan. We went 2-0, and everybody started breaking stuff. It ain't funny. That's why I don't bet. That's why I don't bet. Don't bet. Eagle, shut up. Y'all know what that is? The number of Super Bowl rings the Eagles have. Oh, Pittsburgh. Dallas. Giants. New England. Come on, man. I got it. The Redskins. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, dude. It's human nature. It just everybody else laughed too. He goes, Redskins. Everybody like, shh. Didn't you get saved last night? They got 3 though, but did you get saved last night? Ooh, Miami. Ooh, undefeated. Can we go back to church? The directors are like, one says yes, the other one went, no, they're having a good time. That's all I care.
We'll be right back with more after this break.
I know you're going to dig this.
Like what you're hearing? Head over to iTunes to subscribe, rate, and leave a review. Thanks.
Men of God, we can't keep burning daylight. It's time to rise and shine. Mantour Ministry presents Burning Daylight, The Godly Man's Call to Rise and Shine. This is the most important book we've released yet, as we give a rallying cry to God's men to throw off all complacency and rise and shine. This book is designed to help you know what you believe, why you believe it, and how to recognize the false teaching of progressive Christianity so you don't fall into its trap. It's time we rise from our beds and shine bright to a dark world. Order your copy today at mantourministries.com/burningdaylight. No more burning daylight, men. It's time to rise and shine.
Listen to the Mantour Guy podcast on the go via Apple Podcast and Google Play. Thanks.
Pornography is affecting millions of men, including Christians. Have you seen the effects of porn on your church? Perhaps you feel at a loss when facing the destructive force of pornography. Covenant Eyes is here to help. We created Strive, an anonymous 21-day porn detox for men. Strive will educate and equip men with powerful weapons for this battle. Contact our team today and see how Covenant Eyes and Strive can equip the men in your church to defeat pornography for good.
The Mantour Guy Podcast, helping men grow in their walk with God.
Have you been looking for a Bible study that you can work through with your wife? Maybe you want to do devotional time with your daughter. Guys, we have the answer for you. You can buy both the men's and women's edition of Whatever It Takes for $15. This amazing deal is only available at our Mantour Ministries online store. If you go to Amazon, it is $14.99 for just the men's version. So many men are buying both versions and going through them with their wives and daughters. Do not miss this opportunity. Take advantage of this amazing deal today at mantourministries.com and click on the online store button.
Order your copy today at mantourministries.com. Welcome back to the Mantour Guy Podcast.
Welcome back, guys, as we continue this powerful message together.
Somebody say, long live the king. Hey, you know what I'm doing? You know what I'm doing? I'm a man, dog. I'm a man. We man, dude. We could do that. If it was Sunday morning, we can't talk about football in the middle of a sermon like that. But we man. We could do what we want. If she's not here. Okay, look. I'm just going to tell y'all the truth. My wife is Puerto Rican. There it is. There it is. You know how dudes can cheat on their wife and they take them back? No. Not in Puerto Rico. You die. Y'all think it's funny. It ain't funny. You know who else ain't laughing? All the people married to Puerto Ricans. We be watching the news and they talk about some kind of politician. He left his wife, but she wants to reconcile. And my wife goes, I'll kill you. I'll kill you. And then she just goes to the kitchen and start cutting stuff. And I'm like, baby, can we go buy something? Long live the king.
Long live the king.
Only two more. I got this. Daniel chapter 3. Y'all know this one too. Let me break it down for you. The king, Nebuchadnezzar, said, I'm going to build a big old statue of me, and everybody going to worship me. Everybody going to bow down to me. Everybody going, ooh, me. It's all about me, 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 me. And he did it. And he goes, okay, when the trumpets blow, everybody bow. Everybody bow but three dudes. These three dudes would not bow. Now, the Bible says in Daniel chapter 3, verse 16, that Shadrach, Meshach, and a big Negro replied to the king. It's in the Bible, bruh. He's the original brother. Y'all didn't know. Joe, come on, Joe Jackson. Don't rub your head on me now, man. You my friend. We in this together. All right, I'll change it. Shadrach, Meshach, and the original brother replied to the king. O Nebuchadnezzar, we do not need to defend ourselves before you in this matter. If we are thrown into the blazing furnace, the God we serve is able to save us. Long live the king. Come on, that is cool. They're like, go ahead. He'll save us. But you know what I really like about this is the very next phrase. It says, but even if he doesn't. But even if he doesn't, we ain't bowing. We ain't bowing. Somebody touch your neighbor and say, I ain't bowing. Hey, look at me. Some of you have those struggles that you keep bowing to. No more bowing. If you got to get rid of that iPhone, and go get you one of them flip phones, they ain't got no internet, you go do that. Do whatever you got to do to keep yourself pure. Hey, there's stuff out there. Are you ready for this? Anytime I go online, my wife gets a text on where I go. I'm the cleanest brother in the face of the planet Earth right now. Dude, it wasn't my idea. It wasn't my idea. I was like in the sixth grade. I was playing with ninth graders football. And then one guy opened his locker and goes, ever seen that? I went, oh, my Lord, what is that? That's where I learned about the birds and the bees. That's where pornography came, when I was in the sixth grade. So I protect. I know, look at y'all. Y'all are like, oh, wait a minute. You're a speaker. You're not supposed to be talking about this. Then who is? Dude, who is? Who is? We're men, dude. We're M-E-N or A-N. Whatever you put it, it's still you. And here's the deal. It's everywhere. But just because it's everywhere doesn't mean you have to succumb to it. You got to find something greater to fight for, something greater to live for, something greater to save yourself for. And there's nothing greater than the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. There's nothing greater than him. So you got to do what you got to do. Write it down, y'all. CovenantEyes.com. CovenantEyes.com. You go, you register. I registered my son. He didn't even know it. And somebody said he went on, it gave me a text. Britney Spears. He's on Britney Spears. So I got up. It was Wednesday, and I was speaking at youth group. And I go, I don't care who you are. God knows when you're looking at Britney Spears on the internet, Dominic. He ran to the altar. Gave everything to Jesus, and I still to this day haven't told him. But I put his email on Covenant Eyes, and I know everything. It's my job. I'm his daddy. Hello? I know it's coming across funny and everybody's laughing, but I just showed some of you how to stay clean. You know how you stay clean? Go to your best friend and say, hey, you're going to get a text if I go anything questionable online. Mine is a guy named Preston. Mine is another guy named Dan Betzer. Some of you may have heard of that name. Now I know I ain't going on nothing questionable. He's my pastor. Why? Because I'm in it to win it. I ain't ashamed of my flaws. But I'm more proud of my Jesus. And I will beat myself down before I lose to him. Some of you are like, dude, why do we have to do this? Why do we have to be so strong? Why do we have to win? Why do we have to be the hero? Why do we have to? Because the king has chosen us. So they took Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I said it right. There you go. And they tied them up. The Bible says they were bound and tied and thrown into the blazing furnace. Look at verse 24, Daniel 3, 24. The king Nebuchadnezzar leaped to his feet in amazement, and he looked at his advisors and said, weren't there three men bound and tied that we threw in the fire? They replied, certainly, O king. He said, look, there's four. Wait, here's the good part. Look. There's four, and they're unbound and untied. Long live the king.
Long live the king.
Because even if he doesn't save me, he's going to take me home. Even if he doesn't come through, I'm going to be with him. It's time for us to go public. Time for us to save the day. It's time for us to call our wife and say, baby, I'm sorry. Time for us to look at our own kids and say, I'm going to show you what Jesus is, not just tell you anymore. I could keep going with Daniel in the lion's den. I love that one, dude. No one can pray. No one can pray. Daniel went and prayed, so they went and told on him. You're going to always have people tell on you because they're mad. The king said, I got to throw you in the lion's pit. So they threw Daniel in the lion's den. You know what I really love about this? This is the last one. The Bible says the next morning, the king himself. Hold on. You got to get it? The next morning, the king himself got up and ran to the lion's den and was shouting the whole way, Daniel, are you there? Did your king save you? And the Bible says Daniel shouted, O king, live forever. And you could take that as him saying to that king, live forever. I don't think so. I think he was saying, O king, live forever. I'm still alive. Still alive. Hey, before I go, I think we should start a new hashtag. You know all that hashtag junk going on? Here's what I want y'all to do. If you ended that hashtag, so if you don't know what it is, forget it. It's too late. It's too late, man. Just let it go. You learn how to use the flashlight on your phone. Let's just stop right there for one weekend. Just let it go. Hey, try this. There's only about 185,000 people doing this now. Next time you send a text or a tweet or an Instagram or anything like that, just at the end push hashtag all caps LLK. That means long live the king. See what happens. Just hashtag LLK. You're going to have people go, dude, what does that mean? And you're going to say, long live the king. I belong to Jesus. Long live the king. He belongs to me. Long live the king. No matter what you're going through, long live the king.
Long live the king.
He can save you from anything. Long live the king.
Long live the king.
So just by sending Instagram, you can wave your red shirt and save someone's life. So it's hashtag LLK. On my past, LLK. On my pain, LLK. On my regret, LLK. On my sorrow, LLK. On my loss, long live the king.
Long live the king.
There you go. 254. Oh. Come on, man. Somebody, long live the king.
Long live the king.
Okay, wait. Can I give you something to really clap for? Are y'all ready? My mom, her husband left. I have a brother named Keith and twin sisters, Annette and Jeanette. When my mom's husband left, she lost everything in 7 days, lived on an abandoned farm in a chicken coop. A man walked by on day 8 and said, your kids are crying. What's wrong? She goes, they're hungry. My husband left. He's not coming back. And the man said to her, well, lady, I'll give you $20 if you sleep with me. Your kids can eat if you sleep with me. My mom would do anything for her kids, so she slept with the man for $20. She got pregnant. She had a son. In the delivery room, she was screaming, I don't want it. I don't want it. I don't want it. She asked her favorite teacher at school to help her deliver the baby. In that delivery room, the lady goes, I'll take him. And my mom said, you can have him. You can name him. She goes, I'm going to call him Reginald, which means ruler of many kingdoms. And a school teacher and her second grade educated husband, who was a school janitor, raised me, taught me everything I know. At 8, they told me my story. Do you know what that second grade educated school janitor did? After they told me my story that my mom kept my brother, kept my sisters, and gave me away, I'm crying. He put me in his arms and he goes, look at me. I can't give you my blood, but if you let me, I'll give you my heart. I was set up by God, y'all. I was set up by God. Somebody say, long live the King.
Long live the King.
Okay, look, here we go. You've been here all weekend. You've been hanging out all weekend. But there's some of you, you can't go home with sin in your life. I can't let you do that. So I'm just doing this. We're going to be God's man for the hour. Wherever we go today, and then tomorrow, and the next week, and the next month, and the next year, until he comes back, everything, some of you, is going to echo in your head, long live the King, long live the King. I know, but it starts by you totally deciding. It's Romans 10:9. If you declare with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you'll be saved. So at the end of this honor-bound man weekend, you got 30 seconds to get right with God. If you're in this room and you say, Reggie, I have sin in my life. I got to get right. And it's time for you to go public. I'm going to give you 30 seconds to get from where you are to this altar. We're going to do a sinner's prayer, and they're going to come and close. But you got 30 seconds. You know you got to get something right. There's sin in your life. You've been here all weekend. You've heard all the speakers. Some of y'all are like, this isn't a church way. You're supposed to do this first. I think we should do this just to do this. 28, 27, 26, 25, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20. Come on. 19, 18. 17, 16, 15, I don't care your age, 14, come on, 13, come on, 12, come on, 11, come on, long live the King, long live the King, long live the King, 5, 4, 3, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it, 2, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Somebody just clap for Jesus right now. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Everybody say it. With my mouth, I declare Jesus Christ is Lord of all. I can't change what I've done, what I remember, what I know. But this one thing I do know, because of Jesus, I'm saved. Because of Jesus, I'm not the same man. In Jesus' name, my past is my history, and my future is my destiny. Because now I know. Long live the King.
Long live the King.
And Jesus got my back. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, 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 amen. Amen. Long live the King.
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 What great miracles in the house today. Miracles. There's no greater miracle than a heart that's changed by the power of God. And to see men come and respond. Guys, we've had such a wonderful weekend. Thanks to the Lord. God has met us in such incredible ways this weekend. The messages have found their mark in our hearts and our lives. And so my prayer today, guys, as we begin to bring this thing to a close this afternoon, let's not forget what God is doing. Let's take it home. Let's live it out. Let's make it real. You know, as you get home, you begin to travel home in buses, vans, cars, trucks. Think about what God has done in your life. Think about what things that may need to be changed as you walk into the threshold of the homes that you live in. We need transformation. We need God's continual work in our hearts and our lives. We have been challenged. I've been challenged. We forgive. We take courage. We allow God to continue the work in our lives. We never quit. We never back down. Constantly moving forward. And that's what we do, guys. Constantly move forward in the grace and the power of God's precious Holy Spirit. Tom Rees has done a great, great job in planning. Let's give it up for Tom. Come on, Tom. We do work together in a conference, but Tom has carried such a great load and done a phenomenal job. The staff, Valley Forge College, has been instrumental. A lot of the media that has been done. Let's give it up, Valley Forge, the tech team here at Christian Life Assembly. Christian Walker, and all the guys here that's played, and the band, the worship team. What a great, great job. They've been such marvelous hosts to us. What a beautiful facility to enable to house this conference in. So I want to ask you, let's help them out a little bit. You know, tomorrow's Sunday, they've got to turn this facility over and get ready for their services tomorrow. So I think we could help them if we would just kind of look around the seats, and there's papers and things that need to be picked up, water bottles, whatever. Could you help us do that? Let's just, as a way of showing our appreciation tangibly to the church here at Christian Life Assembly. Great host. We want to be great guests because we appreciate their hospitality. The staff here at the church, phenomenal. And their lead pastor, Pastor Shane Wilson. Would you come, Pastor Shane? Pastor Shane, you're going to close our conference out, my friend. Thank you. God bless you.
Thanks. Hey, before I pray, Reggie, I want you to lead us in I Got Your Back. Okay, everybody. Is it on?
Everybody, here's what you guys do. Everybody stand up. Don't leave. If you leave, your car is going to break down, and Penn State's going to lose by 40. Everybody, take your right hand. Everybody say, I can.
I can.
Not bad, but you got to have a lot of attitude to it. Everybody say, I can.
I can.
Point at your neighbor and say, you can. Everybody take your palms, go like this, and say, we can.
We can.
Last one, everybody say, I got your back.
I got your back.
Cause y'all ready? We got to make it happen like it's real, okay? Everybody, let the black come out of you right now, okay? Everybody say, I can.
I can.
You can.
You can.
We can.
We can.
I got your back.
I got your back.
Say, I can.
I can.
You can.
You can.
We can.
We can.
I got your back. Long live the king.
Long live the king.
Woo!
The Mantour Guy's final thought.
Guys, I hope you enjoyed that message from Reggie. It was such a powerful message, and the man just responded to his cry of long live the king. Even these many years later, I still remember hearing the men scream out, long live the king. And I'm really excited to hear Reggie share once again this year at the Fall Men's Conference. And guys, Reggie's going to be sharing in the Friday night session at the 360 Man Conference. And it's taking place on October 15th and 16th, 2021 at Trinity Life in Lutherville, Maryland. You do not want to miss this conference. And you can still register for this event. If you want to attend in person, you can do that. If you can't make it, you can become a satellite partner and host a satellite event at your church. Both options are being offered this year. So if you want to learn more information about the conference, the speakers, everything you need to know about this amazing conference is available at www.360man.org. That's 360man.org. But guys, you do not want to miss this amazing conference, and we will see you at the 360 Man Conference. Well, guys, we are out of time for this week. Thank you so much for joining us. Once again, I want to encourage you Just take a minute and leave a 5-star rating and review. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts so that we can continue reaching more men. Also, make sure you visit mantourministries.com to learn more about our books, our conferences, our resources. You can sign up for our year-long Bible reading plan there. You can read the first chapter of most of our books there for free. You can read our monthly newsletter. So much more is available at mantourministries.com, so make sure you visit today. But guys, once again, thank you for joining us. We'll see you next week on the Mantour Guy Podcast.
Thanks for listening to the Mantour Guy Podcast. Be sure to visit mantourministries.com to learn more about our books, men's ministry resources, and our mentor conferences.
Hey guys, Jamie Holden here. Did you know that only 10% of churches have a healthy, thriving men's ministry? That's only 1 out of 10 churches. Well, my mission is to see this number become 100%. Join me in my work with HEUS Missions to help develop men's ministry in the local church. Become a monthly financial investor in the work God called me to do by going to mantourministries.com/partner and clicking on the Give Online button. Together, we can see God continue to move among men. Hey guys, Mantour Guy Jamie Holden here. Are you looking for a speaker at your church or for your men's breakfast or your next men's event, men's retreat, or men's conference? Well, why not bring me in to speak? God has been moving among men as I've been sharing an encouraging word of freedom and victory. We're seeing lives change, men being saved, people being set free, and guys, chains are being broken. So if your church has hurting men and women, contact me to come share this encouraging word of hope and victory to help you grow in your walk with God.
The Mantour Guy Podcast, helping men grow in their walk with God.